New York City officials have just signed an $800 million metahuman damages insurance policy for all civic property, prompting fiscal conservatives to complain that the city has resigned itself to massive property damage on a regular basis.
Yeah, well, I'm afraid there, lady, that's something we're just going to have to come with terms with. You can't stop bad guys, and you can't stop the heroes from trying to stop the bad guys. Isn't that right, Magneto? But anyway, what's up, guys? My name's Captain Dave, and welcome back to Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2, where last time we left off, we had finished our secret invasion, secret war, whatever you want to call it, with Lucia von Bardos in Latveria. And then going back to Stark Tower, just have a look at Lou around, chat to some of our compadres, and just basically get the lowdown, see what is going on. But that was last time, and it's time now to get a move on and actually see what is next on the agenda for our superheroes. For this next mission, I do believe I'm going to be using Mr. Fantastic. Well, there's no point going through listing them all one by one. I'm going to be using the Fantastic Four. I think I used the Fantastic Four last time, actually. Last time I did this this mission, like in my previous walkthrough a couple of years ago. I think I used the Fantastic Four then, but what can I say? I just like using them at this point. I was tempted to use another team, but I don't know. It's the only time I feel I'm going to have the Fantastic Four all together as one team. I mean, I could actually use them all later on one team, since I'll be doing pro registration, so I'm going to have Reed Richards with me, so I guess I could do it later as well, but I've already planned out what teams I want to use when, and right now I'm using the Fantastic Four. And seeing as how I have their alternate costumes available as well, I think we'll be switching them up. I'm pretty certain of this, but I could be wrong, because I haven't actually looked it up. I'm pretty certain their alternate costumes are is the costumes they wear in the Ultimate Universe. Because I know in the Ultimate Universe, they're a lot younger, like they're still teenagers, I believe. I haven't actually read Ultimate Fantastic Four, but I do believe that in the Ultimate Universe, they're still teenagers, like Reed Richards is like 17 or something like that. It would make sense, because I mean, looking at these costumes as well, the characters in general, especially some, like what Sue's wearing and Johnny's haircut and Reed's glasses and all that, they just look younger. So, I mean, it would make sense if they actually were, and this was their Ultimate costume, but I don't know for certain, but I'm pretty certain that's what it is. So it's stuck. Stick this auto spend on everything, and definitely on Johnny Storm, because he's going to be getting quite a lot of use out of me. You know how much I love my Human Torch. Let's equip some boosts, because if we've got Johnny Storm with us, we're going to need, and that 20 strike to melee, that's going to definitely come in handy. Let's see if we've got one here for fire attacks deal 5 more damage. I'll definitely take that. Let's see if there's a better one, or is that the best we've got? Focus, teamwork, team fusion, damage, create resistance, gain 10% of melee damage, damage, stamina, 5%. I don't know, I'm kind of thinking of just sticking it on that 9 to power or whatever. I was resistance to fire damage. Raise XP gain by 5% plus 3 focus. These last two I'm kind of looking at and thinking maybe, but I think I'll just stick with Inferno Striker and Team Tactics, why not? As I say, I don't really normally tend to really put much thought into the boosts. I really should, but hey-ho, hey-ho. Rightio, Fantastic Four. Good, good, good. Let's get moving.
Things have been pretty quiet around here lately. I suppose we should have known it was too good to last.
Miss Marvel has been investigating an international gun-running ring in the city. A lead identified this Roosevelt Island construction site as a front for their operations. And last night she reported discovering unexpected tunnels running beneath it. This morning she failed to check in.
Carol can definitely take care of herself, but we'll need to follow up on this just in case. Let's start by investigating those tunnels.
Yes, you smashed that box, Reed. You smashed that box. Reed Richards is actually a character that is actually pretty decent. It's mainly pretty because he's got like the range on some of his attacks, but you'd look at this team and you'd think Human Torch, Ben Grimm.
Intruders! Stop them!
Definitely, we can certainly try to stop us. Susan Storm definitely is a powerhouse in this game. And you ain't the Hulk. I was going to say what happened to the rest of these guys, but I forgot to push this thing at them. But no, the Fantastic Four is actually, as teams go, quite solid. They all hold their own. There's not really a weak link. Yep, I'm on it, Iron Man, or at least I will be once I've destroyed these boxes. Because I see, yep. Focus! Yeah, but all these characters are pretty strong. There's not like one particular weak link.
We got a BOF sighting, big orange fist.
You're damn right, Ben, you're damn right.
That's the end of that.
Yeah, but they're all particularly quite little powerhouses. Susan especially. Actually, Johnny and Susan. I'd say if you were to remove two people from this team, and I don't know why the hell you'd want to do that, but if you could only take two people from this team, I'd take Sue and take Johnny, because they just deal so much damage. It's just brilliant. It's just destroy people all day with it. Plus the fact that Sue can go invisible as well. Just creep behind everyone and then just deal damage. Speaking of Johnny, burn them all! Plus he has that flick up ability as well, so you can just pop them in the air and then keep them up there, Johnny! Playing keep them up with the bad guys. Johnny Storm is just all about fun and games.
Take them down!
Oh, you ain't taking nobody down. Up you go! Keep him up!
What can I say? I'm a hottie.
Yeah, but with abilities like that, Johnny Storm and there's others, I think Storm, even the Invisible Woman as well. It's good, because if you're getting sort of like caught under wraps, you just hit them up like that, pop them up in the sky, and just try and keep them up in the sky for as long as possible, and it can give your time a little bit of, your team a little bit of a breather if you need it. Yeah, even if I hadn't already, decided in advance to use the Fantastic Four for this mission, I probably would have ended up using them anyway. Because just last night, I've started reading the Fantastic Four again. I used to be quite big fans of the Fantastic Four, Spider-Man, X-Men, and Fantastic Four. They were like when I first started reading comics, they were the ones I used to read. And I got into a point where I was reading a lot of Fantastic Four, but as it went on, it just kind of lost its mojo a little bit. It's just, I remember one issue in particular was just
got a thing for the thing, huh?
Oh, who doesn't, Ben? Who doesn't? Boom, baby! But I remember one issue in particular. It was just like Franklin, obviously like the Reed and Susan's child. It's just one about Franklin's birthday party. And I mean, don't get me wrong. I mean, like, stuff like that's still fine, but especially for me, because I was reading them on the good old digital comics, so I was just reading them one after the other. But I can see why, if I was someone who was buying them monthly, I could see how they might be a bit disgruntled that they wait a month for for the next comic to come out, and nothing bad happens. It's just them celebrating a birthday party. I could try to beat up Susan then. Why is it every game I play I end up beating up Susan? What's that about? But yeah, I can see why they would maybe be a bit disgruntled about that. Oh, that punch. That punch of yours, Reed, is so good. But yeah, I can see why they might have been a bit disgruntled if they wait a month for the next Fantastic Four to come out and it's just them celebrating a kid's birthday and nothing really happens. I mean, I personally didn't mind it, but... And then after that, things just, I don't know, it almost felt like they were really having to try to get their stories out. And I don't know, I just kind of lost interest a little bit. But then...
You're very close to a major power source. Take it offline.
Will do, Tony, will do. There's something back there I missed. I'll come back to it later.
Force fields can be a real pain, huh?
You're damn right they can be a pain. They can be painful, too.
Make you into pieces!
Yeah, but she's brilliant. You just go invisible, crush people, throw them, it's awesome. Anyway, but yeah, the story's got a little bit dull after a while. I sort of gave up interest in reading them. But then recently I decided to give it another go. You know, pick up some issues. There was a lot more uploaded to the digital comics. So I thought, I'll give it another go. Stop hitting yourself. And I'm really glad I did.
Petunia's tougher than you.
So I got to the 600 issue of the Fantastic Four, and that story picked it up. It really did. Like all the other stories that you might have been getting kind of bored of before, all culminated into this like one massive issue. And it really was good. It's definitely fueled my love for the Fantastic Four again. Yeah, I'll locate.
Over here.
As you said, let's get Reed. He'll smash it. As you said, Miss Marvel, she can take care of herself for a little bit. I'm looking for secrets. I'm hunting for secrets. I'm hunting for webbits. Thank you. I'll take that. What do we have behind? Wooden block number 2. Zilch, zip, nada, a big goose egg. And just because I'm a little OCD, this blow up everything. There we go. Good, good, good. Now we can move on. Yeah, but like, especially like Human Torch being one of my favourite characters anyway, I was kind of glad to be enjoying a Fantastic Four comic again, because when it was good, I really enjoyed it, and I'm glad to see that it's good again. It's got a lot better. I was even more glad to see that Johnny Storm didn't stay dead as well. I mean, I'm assuming that's not really much of a spoiler, because he came back to life some time ago.
Ms. Marvel reporting in 0600 hours. Communication's still jammed down here, so this recording will have to do for now. This little gun-running operation is anything but. It's a cover for something bigger, with offshore origins, high-tech ordnance, cyborg interface circuitry, and even parts for some kind of siege weapons. Still trying to confirm, but my guess is we're dealing with...
And she was never heard from again. And that right there was a prime example of why Johnny Storm's ability is good. Like, I wasn't trapped behind that thing, but obviously I wanted to listen to the audio log, so I didn't want to move. And I could still just hit people from afar, just sitting behind here, so... You just gotta love the Human Torch. Yeah, as I say, I was really glad to see the Fantastic Four picked it back up again, because I kind of missed the Fantastic Four. And I mean, as a family as well, they're growing quite a lot with obviously Franklin and is it Valeria? Is that how you say it? The child they let Doctor Doom name. The family's growing quite a bit. And
surprised Americans! Did you really think you were finished with LaFerre?
Did you really think you were going to get out of here alive? Flame on, Johnny! Flame on! Right, where was I before these guys interrupted me? Charge, Ben! Nobody stops the thing. You got a thing for the thing? But yeah, like the Fantastic Four's family's growing quite a lot with their children and all their children's friends, and then like friends of the family like Spider-Man, and I think I've already been in there, haven't I? Yeah, I've already been down there, like Spider-Man being part of the Future Foundation and stuff like that, so... Definitely got good places it can go to, I feel. As long as they keep up the greatness, as long as they don't let the story sort of lack and get a bit mundane like it did at one point.
Gravity is working against you.
No, look at this guy here, I didn't realise there was a dude in here. Although, Mr. Fantastic's heavy attack, I'm not exactly quite sure what that's supposed to do. He kind of lunges into him, but it lunges into the characters, but it doesn't really seem to do all that much. It's just exactly the same as his, like, normal X attack. Alright, let's dispose of as many bad guys as we can now, because we really don't want any guys left behind for when we come back here later. Crush him, Susan! Nobody gets out alive. Not exactly a very Fantastic Four thing to say, but... See, look, the destruction Susan causes is just unparalleled.
How much more of this you think you can take, hero? Now, don't keep telling me you came in here alone. Where are the others, huh?
Right behind you.
Come on, you really think... Oh.
Oh, Herman, Herman, Herman. Do you ever cease to make a fool out of yourself? See, this is where Susan's really good. You just turn her invisible and just lay the smackdown and they have no idea where you are. guided. No, we don't want any guided attacks. We want a targeted attack. Ben! Threw me a shocker! Now there's a shock for you, Herman. Oh, what am I doing? Just get the human torch up and use your triangle attack, and it just destroys the health of bosses. Look at that! It's just, the human torch is just so powerful. He's just one of those really OP characters in this game, but I love every second of it. Alright, why am I letting these random henchmen... How did those random henchmen best me? That's just... That's embarrassing. Probably because the rest of my team were just standing there and letting me get punched out by those two. Hang on, Miss Marvel. Yeah, I'll let you down in a second, Miss Marvel. Hang on 1 second. Anything else around here? Oh, another bad guy. I think he's going to wish he stayed in the crate.
I could use some help over here.
If it wasn't for us, you'd still be getting tortured by bad puns from Shocker, so I think thank you is in order.
Thanks. As you can probably tell, this op is a lot bigger than we thought. We need to figure out what these Latverians are up to.
Call Nick Fury, he's all about Latveria. Yeah, I suppose it's his mess, let him clean it up.
We'll contact him soon, but we can't just walk away. There's an old factory above these tunnels. If we destroy the weapons they've stockpiled there, it's bound to slow down their operation.
Okie pokey, let's do this. Yeah, speaking of like, seeing as how we're just speaking to Miss Marvel, and like speaking of like the Invisible Woman earlier as well.
Shocker must be trying to slow us down. What's he keeping us away from?
Yikes! Oh, whoops, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to do a clearing one, but hey, I can do one of these as well. Gets the job done. Not as it's spectacular, or should I say fantastic, as I was going for, but definitely seems to be getting the job done. Yeah, but like speaking of like the women in this game, like Miss Marvel, and Invisible Woman and stuff like that, the women in this game actually pack a punch. They can really deal some damage. I mean, Storm, Invisible Woman, and Jean Grey especially really kick ass. And I mean, then you got other characters like Miss Marvel and who else you got? Oh yeah, Songbird. She's a powerhouse as well. Quite a few of these characters really kick butt.
That should lead up to the factory. You go on ahead. I'm gonna finish exploring these tunnels to look for additional intel. If you need any help, I'll be ready.
You can deal with Shocker later. Trash the Latverian weapons first.
Yep, trashing weapons, that is my forte. You don't have to ask me. Even if you hadn't told me to trash them, I probably still would have destroyed them anyway, just for poops and giggles. Should have stayed inside the container, guys. You just scrap metal. Oh, Thing, are you okay in there? Thing, are you stuck?
Is that a thing for the Thing, huh?
No, well, yeah, actually, I kind of do like the Thing now you mention it, but... Oh, wow! This is an explosive. I was about to say, oh look, there's a collectible behind there.
Drop it! Here they come!
Oh man, maybe blowing up that. I know Human Torch is immune to fire, but I think explosions still do knock me on my ass. Ooh, speaking of explosions, thank you very much. even if you don't care about collecting stuff, how can you just resist blowing up all these crates? It's just it's just too irresistible. Plus, you build up your fusion powers as well. Oh, I should have stayed. I was gonna say, I should have stayed inside the box.
You're wondering, those are only second degree burns.
You're near the first weapons cache. Destroy it.
Can do, will do, Miss Marvel. Will do.
Charge up your baton.
Never play with matches. Or me.
Charge up your batons. That doesn't exactly sound very super villainy. Sorry, I was too busy burning things there, Miss Marvel. I think I got the gist of what you were trying to say, though. Yeah, but one thing I loved about that Fantastic Four issue that I was talking about, like the big 600 edition, was the fact that Human Torch got quite a spotlight in it. Which I think for a character that is as powerful as Human Torch, I mean, let's face it, if he goes supernova in our atmosphere, it would actually ignite the oxygen.
Wouldn't you say?
It'd ignite our oxygen and kill every single living creature on the planet. So I mean, as superheroes go, he's quite powerful. Oh, so you're the head honcho. We better take you out first. But because he's a bit of a comedy carrot, he's a comedy carrot. Because he's a bit of a comedy character, he always tends to take a bit of a backseat.
That'll give you a chance to rethink this.
Especially when you got the likes of Reed Richards in the party as well, and then obviously fan favourite Ben Grimm as well. Let's kill Reed, why not? So he tends to normally take a bit of a back seat, which is a shame, because he is actually a really powerful character. Him and Sue, I think, like, are potentially two of the most powerful characters in the Marvel Universe. Sue can kill anybody with just a fault, and Human Torch can pretty much kill everything everywhere. Jump, Johnny! Oh yeah, of course, that's still grating. That's still grating, it didn't occur to me that it'd still be able to hit me through the floor. Alright, before we move on, I think we've got some stuff we can destroy back here. The actual fact, what we got here? Guided, that's what we're looking for! He came in like a wrecking ball! Look at that arm out! Someone's played American football. Look at Ben Grimm go. He's the quarterback everybody wants on their team.
They're tearing through us. We need backup.
Well, I don't know if that's what the quarterback does. Oh, I don't know American football, but you get the gist. You know where I'm heading with this. But yeah, but that issue of Fantastic Four is the one where, like, sort of, it's not really much of a secret. It's kind of on the front cover, but it's like Johnny Storm's big return. So obviously he has to play a pivotal part in it, but it's just nice to see him finally get a spotlight and actually seem a bit more grown up. Because after everything that's happened, he would have matured a little bit. 5 out of 6. Yeah, 5 out of 6. One more to go, and I've got a feeling it's behind that wall. So let's go down here and do a little bit of smashy before we move on out. I've been using Human Torch a bit, since I'm going to be using him later in the game as well. Let's use the ever-loving blue-eyed thing. Charge those boxes out of the way, Ben. it's a lot easier running when you do that. Give me a bit of health. I didn't realise you were getting smacked down a little bit there. Sometimes I forget the thing is destructible.
Kind of a grim situation for you, huh?
Ha! Ben cracking out the jokes.
That was the last one! Where are the reinforcements?
That'll put a wrench in the work. Now find those villains.
Oh no!
Here
more,
I am.
More tin can toys. Whatever are we gonna do? However will we stop them? Boom, baby! Robot, meet the concrete. Concrete, meet the robot. Yep, you can go over there, see your friend. You can go over there, see your friend. Or I can just throw you into the thing. That seems to do the job as well. I love the elasticy sounds.
We'll hold this line. Go help the boss get everything ready.